Una, good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Depending on the area, waiting for the watch, connect with us this evening. Talk time as it be. We did streets this evening, we're going to continue to the talk time as it be. My name is Apostle Alfred Uyinosa, aka Talk Time as it be. My brother, they here.
And my name still remains Victor Olise. I never ready to change him.
So, my people, Nigeria don't die. You know, say, when they talk like this, some people say, this man a man of God now. Why you talk say Nigeria don't die? Nigeria don't die. Nigeria don't die. So what they talk him as it be. Now, as Nigeria don't die, so it needs revival. It needs revival. So that's why we'll continue to the talk him as it be. When we say Nigeria don't die, this is not a walk. When you know they work, we say don't die. If business not they work, let me say that business don't die. If economy not they work, the economy don't die. So this evening, we dey streets, and we'll continue to talk as it be. My brother, baby, you put man for this matter.
My country people, good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Anywhere on they watch us live from God, we continue to bless all of Una.
Amen.
I don't forget saying the Ogbonge program where they go all over the world, talk am as it be. And today, the matter when we carry come, again, now a follow up to what we do yesterday. Yesterday, after our broadcast, and I believe say 10 minutes after the broadcast, as we finish, now my phone ring, pong pong. As my phone ring, pong pong, now message enter, as I open up, my person they tell me, say, sir, please, can you please help us with anything? We have not eaten. Say the family never eat. Now I tell apostle, which kind of life? Now in person called they leave so. We just the talk finish now. You never reach 10 minutes. Person just drop message. Say I beg anything when we get, when I get. Say they never eat for their house. Now it looks okay fine. I will go take fix, cure this kind of big problem when they happen for our country. We think go come, left, think go come right. What thing we need to do? Now we say our leaders no get our time.
No.
Now time don't come for us to agree. Say nothing they work for this country. And like what you are about to talk before, as nothing they work, I mean this country don't, we don't fear anybody to talk about. Nigeria is dead. Nigeria don't die. We need to realize this fact first, say Nigeria don't die. When we realize this fact, may nobody carry religious come here, them say God forbid. May nobody try them at all. Why? Because you know what the people they face. And if you know what the people they face, maybe because you never start to face them. Nigeria is dead on arrival as we speak right now. So many things know they work for this country. And nobody ready to talk food. All of us, they pray every seconds. All of us, they think, say, our government get what, and our government don't just get our time at all. As we speak now, fear no go allow me to talk what's happened for Edo State today.
Terrible.
Onto insecurity issues. Terrible issues what happened for Edo State today. As me and you, they speak so. Nigeria is dead on arrival. As we speak so, Nigeria is dead on arrival. Nigerians must understand this fact. Say Nigeria don't die first, number one. And then when we understand that fact, Nigeria don't die, we work on the thing of the best way to test how we fit and revive this country. As we speak right now, we get so many students from inside University of Benin, as we speak right now. Those students, when they inside University of Benin, most of them, our ladies don't indulge themselves into prostitution.
Terrible.
What they're not supposed to they do.
What did they not plan for?
Young boys don't enter street, they do Yahoo, they fry hair. They fry here, they fry here, they fry everything. Nigeria is dead on arrival. We need to understand this fact. The Nigerian youth must wake up. See, they do now selection. That's the National Association of Nigerian Student Election. 45 years old man.
Old man.
Now he win as student president
old
for
man.
The country. Everything does scatter. Then we are now saying that we should keep waiting for God. Waiting for God to come and do what? Waiting for God to come and do what? Nigeria is dead on arrival. President Bubu, there's only one thing that you must do right now. Please resign.
Period.
There's only one thing. You have proven to us that you lack capacity to lead us as a people in this country. You have proven to us. You have told us we have so many proofs and facts to hold against you. Please resign. We don't want you to sack service chief. No sack service chief. You are the problem of our country, President Buhari. Please resign. Please resign. We are suffering in this country. From the health sector to the educational sector,
everything
to transportation, to administration, to economy, everything. Everything dead. As we speak, yesterday, we enter one hospital. You believe, say, inside the hospital, people when come greet their patients, when they take care of their patients, they sleep 100 grand.
They sleep 100 grand.
They sleep on the ground.
And then they sleep.
Person get patient for hospital. He can't greet. Now they take care of the patient for hospital. Now they look after the patient for hospital. Now on the ground, on the guy go spray. We go see woman go spray a path for on the ground. They sleep on the ground.
You go see carry another sickness.
They know. You know carry another sickness for nobody. Inside mosquito for there. You will carry pneumonia. You carry go out back again. And you are telling me we should keep quiet in this country. Nigeria is dead on arrival. The president should please resign as the president of this country. Please leave Nigeria. Please resign as the president of this country. Please resign. President Buhari, will they beg your beg? Please resign. Asorok too heavy for you. You don't tell us. Asorok too heavy. Please resign. Thank you.
So, my people, we will continue to the talk as it be. I know some people now begin to form religions. Say that I pray part and I go church part. My brother, nobody in Nigeria, more than go to that country. They only serve God from that country. Tell friend truth, you know the spoil friend. What is not good is bad. Truth, it be like bitter leaf. And we will continue to the talker. Why be say we don't do deceive ourselves rich for this country. We don't do use religions. Tell deceive ourselves for this country. Enough is enough. Now we begin the talker as it be. Nigeria is dead. We must tell ourselves the truth. Nothing is working. Yesterday for Benin Auchi Road, we know how many people they kidnap. Fulani there everywhere now. They kidnap people. They rape our women. They rape our girls. Nothing they happen. They even yesterday, even here for Ekewa Road, they kidnap farmer and other people. People go say, we'll not talk. We'll continue to talk. Nigeria is dead. Nothing is working in this country. Make we stop to the faith. We do the faith everything. Everything are faith. But the Bible says, faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead. Everywhere in our church, we pray a lot. How come? Since 1960, nothing have changed. Something is wrong. We must start telling ourselves the truth. Nigeria is dead. And Nigeria need to be reset in a hurry. We will continue to talk him as it be. We don't fear anybody first. We don't care. So we begin to talk him as it be. Check everywhere. Even I mentioned the Minister for Transport. He said passenger to enter train from Lagos to Ibadan, they're going to pay 3,000 naira. Who does that? What kind of a country is this? Who does that? How can the Minister of Transport be telling the people that between Lagos and Ibadan, 3,000 naira? What kind of rubbish is that? Nigeria is dead. Make we begin to tell ourselves the truth. There is no hope. There is no future for us in this country. Things are not getting better. Things are getting worse. Tell friend truth. In order to spoil friend, say it the way it is.
I meet one of my students this afternoon. Now he says, sir, I gather money, I won't come up for this country. Now I say, where are you going to? He says, sir, I don't know, but I'm leaving this country. I think they count how many Nigerians. As I talk on yesterday, when I say I play. As I do so, I don't really dust my shoe for this country. I don't dust my shoe. Why? Because the Nigerian people are not ready to accept the fact that nothing is working in this country.
They're not ready.
The Nigerian government are aware that Nigeria is not working. They know that Nigeria is not working. But the Nigerian people, me and you, the masses, we have failed to accept that this country is dead. And because we have failed to accept that this country is dead, our leaders say they look us, they leave them. They never tire. When they tire, they will do the needful. Show now, here with this Senate President talk the other day. Senate President, when he tells us to our face, he said, if you are tired of us, he said, change us in the next election. That's to make you understand. Say, even them too, they know say them.
They don't fail.
They don't fail. So then they tell us our face, say, we not say, we don't tire.
We want to
change us. And that is, if you have the time. Now, at the point this question to my fellow youth, what is the tactics that you and I have developed to ensure that come 2023, we'll take over power in this country? What is the tactics? What is the structure that we are currently putting in place? And they attack my fellow youth right now. Me and my fellow youth, I'm talking about them. If you are a youth and you are watching me right now, or you will watch this video after now, please tell me the strategy that you are putting in place. Tell me the community that you are building. When I mean the community where they build, I mean say the people went to, when I don't gather on ourselves, say this country, come 2023, we go lead ourselves to ensure say youth get take over leadership for this country. Which person we want send to go lead us? Who will represent the youth? who will represent our voice. All of us cannot go to House of Rep. All of us cannot go to House of Rep. All of us cannot go to Senate. Who is the real youth representative? Now the big question why they ask the youth now. If we cannot answer this question, then that means that the word Nigeria is dead on arrival.
It's dead.
I beg, don't you follow me arguing. No follow me arguing. And they talk and as I speak. Yesterday, the president of the National Association of Nigerian Students announced the overall body for student union for Nigeria was elected for today. 45 years old man is a civil servant. What is the fan? After that, we go to abuse President Bubu.
Yeah, we said Bubu.
After that, we go to abuse President Bubu. What is our problem in this country? The Nigerian people, can't we wake up? Can't we wake up? I said this a few days ago. It is very difficult for you to see an average Nigerian when go spend 500 naira comfortably a day. When body don't go shake up. We cannot comfortably spend 500 naira on a daily basis. What are you now telling me? More keep going, more look ourselves. How? Do you know how many people that calls on a daily basis because they see us on air, they see us everywhere, pockets full. They call on a daily basis. Please, sir, can you please help us with 2,000 naira? You can imagine. Where full family, where they call, say, may you assist them with 2,000 naira. For papa, mama, and children, three children, four children, will be pleading that you should give them 2,000 naira. It's as worst as that. A country where they increase fuel, all of us kept quiet. They increased the fuel, all of us, me and you, nobody came out to condemn that act.
Increased VAT.
They increased VAT. Me and you don't come out. All the best we could do was to sit on social media and complain. Is that how Nigeria will change? Is that how Nigeria will change? What is the foundation of the future we are presenting for the next generation? The children, the small, small children, what's the foundation? What's the foundation? If they cannot solve this, oh,
you've said it all.
Of the mind, reorientation.
Which we are currently doing now.
We need reorientation. But you'll see some people, they'll see this kind of message. They'll see they follow you, they argue.
They'll see the cost.
They'll say, more go church, more go pray. They'll say, more go mosque, more go pray. What do you mean by that?
Well, what do you mean? I will not be praying.
What do you mean by that? Nothing is working in this country. Look at other countries that had similar issues. Their issue not even reached Nigeria issue. Their president, their prime minister, they resigned. Why? Because they told themselves the truth that they lack capacity to lead their people. But in Nigerian case, now life, if you don't die for that seat, it goes dead here.
My brother, we too they deceive ourselves in this country, especially people who call themselves religious leaders. We too they deceive ourselves in this country. We know they tell ourselves truth for this country. We they use religion, they cover everything. Tell friend truth, you know his boyfriend. So that's why they go to talk to religious bodies. You call yourself Christian. Make we begin to tell ourselves the truth. Not until we begin to tell ourselves the truth, nothing will ever work in this country. Let's begin to tell ourselves the truth. We don't do the deceive ourselves. Nigeria is dead. So we must tell ourselves the truth. There is no hope for the youth. No hope. No hope for the youth. This generation have no youth. No hope. No hope.
So you can imagine a country where IGP sent in all fellow police officers, senior officers, on official operation, that they go for road. Boko Haram come, they kidnap them. They kidnap them, finish. After many days, Nigerian government pay money to Boko Haram to release them.
Ew.
And when they kidnap one American citizen, enter our own country in Nigeria,
they can't release them.
They don't use money, they pay ransom. The American soldier enter Nigeria, they carry the American citizen, kill six Nigerians, come out. So, American soldier and Nigerian soldier, who know Nigerian map pass?
Who know the map pass?
I'm gonna answer now. Nigerian soldiers and American soldier when come, who get the country? So they came in a space of how many hours? They capture those dirty bandits, they kill them, they carry their citizens alive.
They move.
Nothing touch and nothing scratch your body.
What a shame!
Nothing. That was not enough. After that, no single word from the president.
He no know. President no know.
No single word.
He no know.
From the president.
He's not aware.
So I tell you, say this kind of thing happened.
President's not aware.
He did not condemn the fact, the act. He not appreciate him. He did not say anything.
He's not aware. He no know.
Just today, on our Minister for Information, Lai Mohammed, he opened his mouth wide. They talk, say the president cannot resign. say because imagine the word where he say because bandits key rice farmers now we come to say make the president resign. Say it's childish.
We can't say that people.
You know, they talk about it. Say it's childish. But I know why he took that kind of word. Because he no say, he no get what we do.
That's it. They don't see us finish.
They know.
They don't see us finish.
They no say, you know, they no say, you know, get. The best we can do
well, to shout.
Is to rant on the social media.
Finish.
They know. That's the best we can do. To rant on the social media. But I want to seek this opportunity to tell our security agencies, when I know the truth. Your families are suffering. Nigerian police force, military, all of una. See all of una family, they suffer. Una know.
Army.
How many of una don't you buy Christmas clothes for our children?
I'm not sure where they want for see money.
How many of una don't you buy Christmas shoe for our children? How many of una don't you buy one delica of rice for Christmas people house? But yet, you people cannot open your mouth and tell the Nigerian government the truth. And I love to use wisdom. Tell them, say no. It's high time for us to change this country. The order will now come out. We will carry that heavy gun. Gun where every person knows that thing. We will carry them. They misbehave on streets. You people should continue. But I know that someday, like the prophecy of Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., someday, I don't know that day, but someday, a generation shall arise in this country. It took our generation 60 years to stand up and lead the NSAS protest. But someday, a generation shall arise and they will ask the right question. The question that they will ask, I don't know yet, but they will ask that right question. And that right question, when they will ask, the consequence of their question,
it go tough.
If we cannot find answer to their question,
they will collect.
We will all now know what will happen as a nation. But we will continue to talk without fear or favor. That the government will do anything, either good or bad, at all, we will continue to talk. We have chosen to be the sacrificial lamb, to be the voice of the voiceless in this country. We don't choose to say we will talk, they go. Anyhow, when I want to do one, we will continue to talk as it be. As we speak right now, Nigeria is dead.
It's dead.
We need to accept this fact and then decide to build Nigeria back or collapse Nigeria finally.
If my papa failed me, I no go fail my children. If my papa failed me, I no go fail my children. That's why we'll continue to talk as it be. Everything about this country is grounded. Insecurity is on the increase. Business don't go area. People that were carrying collect money from Lapo, they can't pay it back.
At all.
People are collect loan from bank, can't pay back. Why? Because nothing is working.
The business has drowned.
The system in Nigeria is completely collapsed. I don't know what our leader take us for. So enough of this fake declaration. But we'll continue to tell ourselves the truth. See our youth, they are roaming around the street. Nothing. Insecurity everywhere. Up to Abuja, insecurity. I get a report from somebody this if they won't go great. Say for Abuja, Federal Capital Territory.
No lights.
Apart from that, he enter keke. Some people try to enter. He don't know. Now the driver called him and said, now he phone. Then the band chief.
Fantastic.
You understand? So, Nigeria is not safe. A country that is not safe simply means the country is dead. So now, what is the way forward? We must begin to tell ourselves the truth. Enough of this sentiment. We don't deceive ourselves rich. We don't too deceive ourselves rich. The Nigerian Army, remember you have family. The Nigerian Police, remember you have family. The Navy and the Air Force, remember you have family. To take care of. Why not sit down to think? Why not sit down and think? Una allow politicians to use una.
Anyhow.
They use una, they kill masses. So the Nigerian Army, the Nigerian Navy, the Nigerian Police Force, it is time for you guys to stand up to defend the unity of Nigeria. It is time for you guys to stand up to defend our youth because nothing is working. Remember, the Nigerian Police will not get on that farm. The Nigerian Army will not get separate markets. Remember, una children not get separate school. Remember, una not get separate hospital. Una not get separate motor. Now, when they affect a common man, it affects una family. Remember, una come from family. Nigeria Army, Nigeria Police, DSS, why not they allow the Nigeria government, they use una against the masses. It's totally unacceptable, and we are not going to take it from anybody anymore. Enough is enough of this oppression.
Now, Nigeria, you go see. When person go spend, go university, course when supposed to do for 4 years, because of their dirty ass strike, you go use 6 years, 7 years, take go to school. You go come finish. Now that time they will come, they tell us, may go learn tailor.
May go learn tailor.
Now that time they go tell us, may go learn how to barb hair.
May go learn hairdressing.
Now that time they go tell them, say may go learn how to do ties.
May go learn how to do
now
shoemaker.
That time, they will tell them, may go learn how to do shoemaker.
Even shampoo.
After you don't spend 7 years for university, why you know a lot of boy go learn that ties? He said, may no go school. Why you know a lot of girl make you go learn tailor or hairdresser? He said, you allow her to wait 7 years for university. Now when she can't finish school, now you say, may she go learn how to make
it. Wicked people.
Wicked people.
Meanwhile, I want you to be abroad.
They are abroad, they enjoy themselves. They just ensure, say, they kill the system of this country such that you're not going to feel work at all. You're not going to feel work at all. So you see the Nigerian youth, we move all about everywhere, day and night, with the fact we tell us by our own self. It's a big shame to each and every one of us. Me and you, where they watch also. It's a big shame to each and every one of us. The Nigerian government has proven to us that they don't have our time. They don't trust us, they don't get our time. Now, me and you, this country got their hand. It's either we make this country or this country collapse finally for our hand. It's either we make this country or this country will collapse finally for our hand. The Nigerian people must wake up. The Nigerian youth must wake up. It's high time the Nigerian youth must begin to start to educate their parents. Some of their parents, when they fear, say, "Mona, don't come out." Time don't reach Mona, they tell us, say, "Mama, nothing will happen for me. We need to come out to fight for this country." It's high time the Nigerian parents who are educated about the information and happiness about this country begin to tell their children, say, "The fate of this country lies in your hand. This country can never be great until you join well-meaning Nigerians to make it great. This country can never stand for what we are supposed to be known for until the Nigerian people come out in one accord to agree and accept that this country belongs to Nigerians. And Nigeria can never be great until Nigerians take responsibility. Nigerians, we must wake up. Nigerians, we must agree that Nigeria is dead. We must agree that nothing is working in this country. Nigerians, we must agree and we must accept to this fact that the Nigerian government has proven to us over and over again that we can't do anything. That the Nigerian government has proven to us over 1,000 times that they are clueless about what it takes to lead this country. The Nigerian people must accept that it is high time that we take over leadership in this country. It is high time our leaders must be accountable. It is high time our leaders must be transparent. It is high time that we have somebody in the leadership affair who will come out and say, "Yes, I am for the people." It's high time that we have senators when go come, when they go say, "No, we don't need official cars." It's high time when we get out of rep, will come and say, "We don't need wardrobe allowance." Can you please tell me what is wardrobe allowance? What is
newspaper allowance?
What is newspaper allowance in this technology?
Recharge allowance.
What do they need all that for? All that expenses that just to hike the budget and then ensure that the expenditures of this country go high and make the masses suffer more. How much Nigeria they allocate for agriculture?
Zero.
How much Nigerian government they allocate for education?
Zero.
How much?
Zero.
Go and compare the amount that Nigerian government they allocate for agriculture when Nigerian government they allocate for education and then compare to the amount they allocate to buy new motor.
What a shame.
New motor for what? New motor for what? Senators, when they elect, when supposed to their constituency, all of them go Abuja, go sit down. Do what in Abuja? The Nigerian people must wake up. Why? Because those senators, they represent a particular senatorial district. Those House of Rep, they represent a particular senatorial, they represent a particular district. The Nigerian people must wake up. The Nigerian people must accept. Say from now henceforth, we must continue to educate ourselves. The Nigerian people must accept that from now henceforth, we're going to talk to ourselves make we know say this country is dead on arrival. And as such, that come 2023, we mobilize ourselves in full force to go and vote. The other day, we give the statistic of Nigerian youth. When they are accredited to vote, over 43 million Nigerian youths. They are accredited to vote, and INEC gets about 83 million registered voters. Out of the 83 million, 43 million are Nigerian youths. How many million bring in the president? If you collect the vote of APC and PDP, it's about 26 million. You don't even reach half
my brother,
of Nigerian youths.
No go far. Are you aware that federal workers have not received salary?
Okay.
Today is 4th of December. Workers have not received their salary.
Okay.
Workers, federal workers, health workers have not received salary. So when we say the country is dead, we know what we talk. 4th of December, last month's salary, people never collect salary. Workers have not received their salary. And some people now begin to say, oh, faith, my brother. Don't be faith. Make we tell ourselves the truth. And then when they tell the people why they never pay workers' salary. Today is 4th of December 2020. Workers, federal workers, never receive salary. Why? Nobody they talk to us. That's why we talk to Nigeria, don't die. We must tell ourselves the truth. And Buhari resign.
He should resign.
Resign.
One use this medium. They talk to our state governors, most especially in the South-South region. It's not going to be out of point. Say, as you speak, the governor of Edo State, Governor Obaseki, nothing stop you from building Edo State. Nothing stop you from making Edo State be autonomous of its own. Nothing stop you. Nothing stop you, sir. Nothing stop Governor Okowa, the governor of Delta State. Nothing stop you now. Nothing stop the governors in the South to come together and say, can't we have a refinery? Now, when they shout, say, now, when I get oil, when I get oil, when I get a refinery.
No longer build. Where did you stop from buying that refinery?
The Delta, the South state governors, where did you stop now from saying, okay, fine. How much? The other day, we give a statistics of how much to build refinery. To build refinery between of capacity between 250,000 diesel to 500 is about, it's between $5 billion to $15 billion. Then we don't get, we overget them. We overget them. So what is stopping us from building a refinery? The South-South governors. What is stopping us? Nothing. It's not be Buhari. Not be Buhari say, we don't do them. Can we come together? Can we be united to accept that this country is dead? And because this country is dead, we must begin to unite ourselves from states to regions. I begin to ask, what can we do together?
My brother, but you dare aware say Fulani don't take over those states. In fact, not be those states. The Fulani are taking over the whole country. All the crime right now is being carried out by the Fulani terrorists.
That for every borders.
Then every city, then every state, our state governors, all from South South, una yon keep quiet. The Fulani have taken over. Then everywhere. The day road, in form of street begging, some day junction, Latino they sell orange, they have taken over. The Fulani have invaded our nation. They have invaded our city. South-South governor, make una wake up. South-South governor, make una wake up from una bed of slumber. I take action now, because we dey talk am now. Una go say we dey make noise. We dey talk am.
So, now, very little message we get for now. Let's begin to educate ourselves. More to tell ourselves the truth. First, we need to agree. If we don't agree, then Nigeria doesn't work. We need to agree. Why? Because if we don't agree, then before you know, a person goes there, at least I see they see fuel by per liter 170. I feel
happy.
But is it supposed to be so? Don't forget that this same president, in his manifesto, he told us. Say if you enter for a first tenor,
you reduce fuel.
You go reduce fuel to 14 naira per liter. Now you talk about yourself. That means say you don't get strategy. But what you have when you enter? When you enter,
he tell us say
inherit bad governance. Now for over 5 to 6 years now, you see the inherit bad governance.
Inherit bad governance, see the chop or table.
You see the inherit bad governance. So what are you telling me? All right, Mrs. Mabel, the Senate, you don't even give their name. The Senate is, the legislatives, the representatives are receiving huge amount of money for doing absolutely nothing
100% correct.
In the parliament that affect the common masses in the country. 100% true. That they receive thousands and millions of naira. Millions of naira for sitting down under better AC.
To say to talk rubbish.
So the AC they may get the sleep. They will enter plenary. When they're supposed to they report cases or waiting for their questions, they will enter, they will go to sleep. What are you now telling me? Time don't reach for us to begin to educate ourselves. Time don't reach for me to know what you know, for you to know what I know. So when we come out, we'll be able to speak one voice. When we come out, we'll be able to agitate for one better country. Time don't reach for us to understand. Say this country, America don't come build this country.
No.
As we speak right now, Rwanda just launched their second international airport. Second international airport.
Not be mama you.
Rwanda just launched them. We have our own. Where is our Nigeria Airways? Where, as we speak today, where is our Nigeria Airways today?
Nothing.
It don't go. It don't go as we speak today. Where is our Nigeria? All our Nigerian government, all waiting there, know. Now just to sit down. They expect, say, oil they come. They expect. I support you, Sir Powell. I support you. It shall never be well with our evil leaders.
Amen.
The looters.
Amen.
When they loot the wealth of this country.
Amen.
They don't suffer us rich. I know that they talk. At their streets, they don't suffer us for this country. Without fear or favor, I know that they talk. They don't suffer us for this country. And that is why we don't choose to see ourselves as the sacrificial lamb. We don't choose to be the voice of the voiceless for this country. To continue to the talk camp as it be. So people will say, eh? We don't know the fear. What is which dirty presidency?
Who?
Presidency don't help itself.
They don't pass. Itself.
We will say this over and over
they
again.
They don't pass.
It never help itself. Why? Because say, they don't choose to see, say, we know if we do anything. And because they tell us we know if we do anything. We serve, we go tell them, say, our legs stand, give it back for grant. Our legs stand, give it back for grant. And both physically and spiritually, we'll continue to deal with the Nigerian country, evil leaders. As we talk yesterday, from now henceforth, as we declare yesterday, cancer.
They're going to carry them.
They will carry cancer.
That's their portion.
Cancer.
That's their portion.
All the evil leaders in this
they
country.
They go collect them, double.
All the evil. For South, for North, for East,
for West.
For West.
Una go collect.
Anywhere una day.
Now collect.
All the evil leaders in this country. The blood of the innocent.
We continue to cry against all of you.
We are not shared for this country.
We continue to cry against
all
of you.
We continue to haunt all of you. We continue to haunt all of you. Cancer with the castle of una.
My people, tell friend truth, you know they keep friends. What is not good is bad. One of the major problems for this country, say we do they deceive ourselves. We know they want to tell ourselves the truth. We they pretend. You know, say you know they where. You say it is where.
Yeah.
For me, it is nowhere with Nigeria. You know they where. Nigeria is dead. You have a dead leaders. When you have a dead president, what do you expect? Dead economy. When you have leaders that are dead in thinking, you have dead economy. So everything about the country is dead. And they tell us about not talk. We go talk. We go continue to the talk until change come. Until change come. The Nigeria of our dream. I have a dream that one day, all the evil looters, all the treasury looters, they will travel on a journey of
they
no
will
return.
Never return.
They will embark on a journey of no return.
Soon, Apostle, as you say one day, let's say far.
Now, from this moment, all evil leaders in this country,
amen.
Whether from the north, whether from the south, whether from the west, whether from the east, all of them are embark on a journey
amen.
Of no return.
Amen.
It don't do. We don't deceive ourselves rich. We don't tire. and things must change. And we go continue to tell ourselves the truth. We're not gonna look anybody face again. Because it not get what you not gonna fit do.
At all, at all.
But I mean we my head. We not get what you not gonna fit do us at all. We not turn our youth to vagabond. We not turn our youth to arm robber. Why? If we not make things work, our youth are ready to work. But all the evil leaders, we know they make you the work for this country. And when I carry our children go abroad, now they are dead, but you're not going to carry for street.
Amen.
When I go see them, all the evil leaders, where people that they destroy our economy, when they sponsor our children for abroad, now they are dead, but they go carry come back.
Amen.
When I go see them.
Amen.
When I go see them.
Amen. 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 In the name of Jesus, amen. Way forward. First and foremost. Nigerian people.
We'll begin to tell us the truth.
Educate the next person when they're close to you. No matter where you day, you day abroad, anywhere you day for this world, begin to educate the next person when they're close to you. Time don't reach for all of us to begin to reorient ourselves, to know what we are supposed to know, to have the right information. The Nigerian people, if you don't get your PVC, I beg, go and get your PVC.
Let me let PVC, my brother.
No, is this a way forward? It's a way forward, sir. Go and get your PVC, the Nigerian people. Why? Because it is also a strategy when we go use, when the right time comes. Anyhow, the same one will give them any other thing one time. Time don't reach. If you don't have your PVC, as they watch this video, so go and get your PVC. My man, if you live in UK, I never travel. Maybe I never travel, live in UK. Stop, I live in UK with this, so good evening, man. And so, also, let the Nigerian youth begin to create a community where they feel they talk to themselves, they teach themselves the right thing to do. I beg, 5,000 naira. 2,000 naira, 10,000 naira, 50,000 naira, please don't sell your vote. I understand, say, with the hungry, but please don't sell your vote. Your vote counts. Yes, your vote counts. And make I tell you how your vote counts. The 2020 Edo State governorship election
shows that the voter can.
Shows, say, when the people come out in mass,
decide
to vote,
there is not anybody
for
can
a
do.
Particular choice. Eh? There's nothing the Nigerian government can do. So, as a matter of fact, your vote counts. I beg, your vote counts. My vote counts. Please, if you don't come out to vote, and I don't come out to vote, the evil leaders, they will still get their ways to get themselves to office. But when you and I come out in mass to vote for the kind of our choice, they will have no option than to pack their bag. You see where they pack their bag for Edo State.
Mm.
All of them pack their bag quietly.
Evil leader, pack your load and go. Evil leader, pack your load and go. If you dare so rock, pack your load and go.
Yes,
so. Evil leader, pack your load and go. If you dare send it, pack your load and go. Evil leader, pack your load and go. If you dare have ass of repo,
pack your load and go.
Pack your load and go. If you be state governor, pack your load and go.
Pack your load and go.
If you be stakeholder,
pack your load and go. Pack your load and go.
If you be businessman,
pack your load and go. Pack your load and go.
Make me pay this call. Hello, good evening. Yeah, God bless you.
Yeah, good morning, good evening, good day, good afternoon for you.
Good evening for you.
Okay. Now we go back. This is the news. You want me to put your money? Now we go back. You want me to go back?
Ira. We are on Facebook Live now. That program. I'm on Facebook Live. At that program. All right. Sorry, my people. for the distraction.
You have said it though.
Nigeria is already shaking. Nigeria is dead.
Buhari must resign. Oga Bubu, please leave us. I beg now. Abi, we'll see they beg you to lead us.
Buhari, resign. Oh,
I beg, resign. Please, I beg, resign.
When you have, when the head is bad,
everything, everything sinks. Please resign, I beg. We are suffering in this country. Suffer too much. All sectors, none is working.
Nothing.
None of the sectors, they work.
Nothing.
I beg, Biko, I beg, leave us now, I beg. I beg, leave us. I beg, resign, I beg. Allow people who understand management. Allow people who understand leadership. Let them come in. Abi, shame on the cash now. Lai Mohammed.
Lala, grandfather of Lai Department.
Gaba Shehu. Shame on the cash now.
Another stupid man. Not a shame.
Shame on the cash now. Are you people not ashamed of what's happening in this country on a daily basis?
They are not as because they never came member of their family in Akosan.
Are you people not ashamed? With a shame, we Nigerians, with a shame.
If member of their family, they are among those who Boko Haram king, they for not the talk. Because if their family member not there among those who Boko Haram king, now make them the talk today. Now calamity could visit them from
the name of Jesus.
If you are a Nigerian politician, you are the one making us to suffer the midst of plenty, and suffer will kill you. Anyone that is after us
in the name
for saying the truth, may calamity visit you
in the name of
as
Jesus.
As you are nothing evil in your heart against us,
blindfold them.
That evil will swallow you.
Amen.
Anybody we pay money to say, go and look for those young men, they will die by accident.
In the name of Jesus.
If they fly the aeroplane, they will crash, they will die. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Okay, yeah.
Amen. So now, so yeah, 80% of Nigerian youth has have been poisoned by their evil, by the evil leaders.
You said it all.
You're very true. And ask me how much they give them.
10 naira.
How much? How much?
15 naira.
Penny. How much? How much they give them when they tell them misbehave? How much they give them when they tell them misbehave? Penny. They give them to misbehave. They give them. When I imagine during the NSAS protest, how they feel take. Talk to some dirty youth.
Give them 200 naira.
Give them change.
200 naira.
Give them gun and cutlasses.
What
to
a shame.
Chase innocent and harmless citizens.
What a shame.
Innocent and harmless citizens. Sense no tell them. Say the man, when say man, I go carry that gun. So where is son?
His son there abroad, a job. They
idiot.
Enjoy.
The woman, when say man, I go carry that cutlass. Where are daughter?
He there abroad.
Their children, they abroad, they enjoy. And they are sending you to carry guns and cutlass to go and kill innocent Nigerians. I used to be the carrier, the exhibitor.
You dey happy?
You dey happy? Every day for the thief.
One day for the owner.
One beautiful day for the owner. And the day when Nemesis will catch up on Una, is near. The day when Nemesis will catch up on all of Una, is near already. Nemesis will catch up on all of Una, is near already. That's why we seek this moment. To tell our fellow Nigerians that Nigeria must work.
Things must work, oh.
You don't get how President Bubu wanted to drag him. Oga, you must resign. We will drag this matter until you pan out.
You must resign.
You must resign.
Move!
Why? Because you don't tell us that you don't get capacity to lead.
What is a bad boy? You are a bad boy.
You cannot lead us.
All the supporters, you get a bad boy.
All of Una.
Bad boys.
You can't lead us. Osibanjo, Abeg, cover your eyes.
Osibanjo, you are a bad boy.
Cover your eyes. You cannot lead us.
Femi, you are a bad boy.
You people don't have what it takes to lead this country. I want to seek this moment to appeal to everybody when get stage. If you know, say, in one way or the other, you be pastor. If you know, say, you be imam.
Change your message.
If you know, say, you be comedian.
Change your message.
If you know, say, you be anything when you know say
change your message.
Two or three people they listen to you.
Change your message.
Change your message.
Now.
What we need to be talking about is reformation in Nigeria. What we need to be talking about is to restructure Nigeria. What we need to be talking about is to ask the president to leave us alone. Why? Because the president has proven to us that he can no longer lead us. The president has proven to us that he lacks the capacity. He lacked the capacity in management.
Do we have president?
To lead us.
We don't have president.
As a matter of fact.
We don't have.
As a matter of fact.
We don't have president.
I seize this moment to say that if you have the stage, you'll be pastor, you'll be imam, wherever you be, please change your message. We need a message of revival. We need a message of rebirth. We need a message of mind reorientation. When the Nigerian people will fit there, agree and accept, say time has come for us to change this country. We are no longer afraid of what the Nigerian government can do to us. In short, we don't see the worst of Nigerian government. The Nigerian government can never do anything to us as we speak.
Nothing.
The best they can do
is to arrest,
to kill. That's the best they can do.
Enough.
And they cannot kill. Why? Because we are dead in Christ. And anybody who is dead in Christ is already dead. And you can never kill him again. You just be saying you want to kill Jesus again. You can't kill Jesus again. Anybody, if you not say, they watch this video, eh? They come, they say they won't use you. Eh? I bet you, as under the plan now, even like, before your generation.
You will die of cancer.
Evil.
Heart attack.
Evil.
You will develop kidney failure.
Even before your generation.
Yeah.
Do you know why? Because I am not fighting for myself. Apostle is not fighting for himself. We are fighting for a nation. We are fighting for the future of the next generation. And so, as they watch this video, so they come, they say they won't tell you, may go to see as you are the planner, eh?
Calamity,
if, not just you, but I mean your generation.
They were going for it.
Your generation, since anybody in your family has refused to train you and give you the right information not to put your hands in evil, and because of that, your family will suffer for it
forever.
They will suffer for
forever.
It. So, please, enough. A word is enough
for the wise.
For the wise, listen very well and listen carefully. Why? Because as I talk to you, I never chop. I am speaking from the anger from my heart. Why? Because this country, to eat, will be like a problem. Not because there's no food, but because you cannot eat and the food will sink in your tummy.
Ow.
Why? Because here and there you're going to receive call upon call. How would that food sink in your tummy?
Test message.
How?
I've not eaten. I've not eaten.
These people are hungry.
How you want to eat belly full?
The country is not working. And somebody is telling me that we should keep hoping. Somebody is telling me we should keep praying. Pastor, change your message.
Change them.
Imam, change your message.
Have we not been praying?
You have prayed enough in this country. God has told us that I have given you people power to rule over this earth. Go and take possession. You must take possession of this country. Time don't reach for all of us to understand. Say, I will continue to share this message. I will continue to share this broadcast. Make who never hear, make it hear. Make who never day inform, make it day inform. Make we not say, one day go come. If we don't share the right information, the wrong information will fly.
And, go,
and when the wrong information fly,
calamity goes strike.
The anarchy, when it go bring about, me and you don't go feel control.
My brother, where the IGP still away for? To deploy tactical team. May they go beneath Lagos, beneath Uchiri Road. Where the IGP still away for? To deploy the tactical team. So may they go beneath Uchiri Road to combat a crime. Where they stop them from building a base in that area? That was sit down for Abuja and talk rubbish. You say you don't want anybody want to protect, that's when I go fire on the evil leader. See, I'll not be pastor, I tell him, I'm an apostle. Pastor will burn it, but apostle will tell you the way it is. We are not afraid of anybody. Pastor will garnish it, but apostle will tell you the way it is. And we are not afraid of any of you. IGP, deploy your men to Benin Uchiro.
Sir, you should resign.
Oh, you resign.
Do you have any men?
What's that? Who are they, Chris?
You don't have any men. The Inspector General of Police, do you have any men? You don't have any men. Why? The men, when you get, shame on you.
Shame.
Boko Haram kidnapped them with their guns.
Shame.
We never heard on the news that they exchange bullets.
Nothing.
They kidnap your men.
You are happy?
Fully armed.
You don't
talk. You went to pay ransom.
Shame on you. Shame on you.
And you're telling me to trust in your own security architecture? What secret architecture do you have?
Who even know whether or not be the good get hand? Chef. Now, they empowered those Fulani terrorists. Our security, some of our security agencies, now they encourage those terrorists, now. Because when I see one person, when he go hold small knife, when I go arrest him. But if Fulani go hold gun, when I let them pass, nobody encourage them. Now we see him.
My country people, this is Nigeria. And the situation when we face for Nigeria. We not go bend mouth, hide anything. Why? Because they get what we stand for. And what we stand for?
Truth.
As talk him as it be.
Talk him as it be.
So we say it the way it is.
Talk him as it be.
Thank God say we did the era of technology. We will stand for anywhere. We're going to share our message. And we're going to ensure say we continue to educate the people. And they remove the people from the shackles of ignorance. We're going to ensure that we continue to spread the good message and to build the hope for a better country. Don't forget that I will never relent.
Never.
I will never relent.
Never.
In the fight for a better country.
No amount of intimidation.
I will never relent. I will never lose hope that this country can be better. We believe strongly that this country must work. And that is why we are saying Nigeria is dead. And because Nigeria is dead, when Jesus died,
he resurrected. Nigeria is dead.
And so we are saying Nigeria is dead.
Nigeria is dead.
For it to be resurrected again.
And we need revival now. We need revival.
So please, you must join this crusade. This is a crusade. You must join this crusade. You must join this movement. You must continue to share on your wall.
We move.
We move. And we are moving to a desired nation. We move, we will never relent. Please, as you get this information, so share this piece. As you get educated, so help us write down for your world. Help us share message for your world. You get why? The reason we say that person, when you get access to this video, he get them. If you look say now, true, I need to join this crusade for us to make Nigeria great. We are not ready to carry guns.
No.
We are not ready to shoot bullets.
Now I'm out.
But guess what? We have it upstairs.
We are using our brain.
We have it upstairs.
We are using our brain.
We are better than those thugs hired by the Nigerian government.
Hired by the stupid Nigerian government.
Hijack the peaceful protest.
The stupid Nigerian government.
And we have gone back to our drawing board. And we are re-strategizing. And we are on the street as well. Please help us tell who never hear. Make it hear. So this country don't die. And because this country don't die, we are saying it must wake up.
Nigeria arise! Nigeria arise! Nigeria arise for a better future. And it is now. Where are the youth? Rise up! Fathers and daddy, mommy, rise up! The second wave of the protest. Una go here. So, we will continue to educate our youth. We will continue to educate until na year world, until na learn. We will get a program to educate una. Una long will show. But yet, una prefer to go sit down to watch pornographic movie, to watch Big Brother Nigeria. Sit down to learn. We don't see una. But by whether I like him or not, una must learn.
Amen.
By fire, by force, una must learn.
Orientation must change.
Una orientation must change. We can no longer be used by any stupid politician again. Enough is enough. I select my language. But time has come for us to begin to say the way it is. Talk him as it be. We are merely human. Enough of this pretentious spirit. We too they pretend for this country. We are smiling and suffering. We too they pretend for Nigeria. Make we tell ourselves the truth. My brother, tell friend truth in this boyfriend.
At all.
What is not good is bad. We move. We are not afraid of anybody. We will no longer keep quiet and allow that our brothers and sisters be killed every day. Our brothers and sisters are being slaughtered like chicken every day. They are kidnapping our brothers and sisters every day. The country is not safe. And nowhere is safe in the country. Nigeria is dead. Enough is enough. And we cannot take it anymore. Buhari, all of you should resign.
I beg, Muna, resign. I beg, President Buhari,
resign.
Please resign. I beg. Please resign. It will not take anything away from you. When Ebele Jonathan, see say, Ebele say, he get the way he won't be.
Now resign.
He called you. He called you. He said, oh God, congratulations. He come out, Abi. I beg. You two resign. Nigeria too heavy for you. Please resign. I beg. Please resign. We are tired of your governance. Your governance, we have no clue on the way forward of your governance. We don't know the direction where they lead us to go.
Direction of backwardness. Buhari,
we don't know.
You and your family take us back to 1975. No, 1945. Backward.
We don't know where they lead us to go again. I beg. Our eye don't clear.
We're
tired.
Know
we know they go again.
We're tired.
Our eye, you don't clear. I beg. We know they go again.
We're tired.
Please, can
drop
you please
us. Drop us. Us?
Come
please.
Out as a pilot. I beg.
Buhari, please drop us. We're tired. We can't follow please. You again.
Please leave us alone. At least you have fought to become the president of this country. You don't contest. Finally, you don't win. Your name don't enter the book of people who don't leave Nigeria. I beg, resign.
Period.
What did you define again? You define me, your name enter the list of people who don't leave Nigeria, Abi. Your name don't enter. I beg, resign. Resign, please. We have seen your capacity as a leader. And you don't help us carry the fuel, go where you're supposed to go.
Bad
resign.
Man. Buhari is a bad boy.
You know how much be $1 to speak right now?
Bad boy.
About 500 naira to $1. It's appalling. 500 naira
what
to $1.
All of you.
What for?
Shame.
Please resign as the president of this country. We are appealing to you. Please resign. I beg, resign as the president of this
Buhari
country.
Buhari is a bad boy. A bad boy.
Resign. We beg you. We understand that you are clueless about what it takes to lead us as a country. Please resign.
You don't have the
as
capacity.
As the president of this country. You lack the capacity to lead us as a president. What else again are you looking for? You are already the president of this country. And you have led us for about 5 to 6 years. It's enough. Don't wait for 8 years. Please resign.
Please, we know if we follow you
again. We can no longer bear it. Please resign.
As of today, federal one can never receive salary. But yet, all the senators, you guys have paid yourself. President, you have paid yourself. Osinbajo, you have paid yourself. But workers have not received their salary. Stupid set of people. Stupid set of people. Enough is enough.
So, we not say our message don't sink. We will never relent. We will never retire. And we will never be discouraged. We understand, say, in a time like this for our country, change when we dey call for, no fit happen once. We know. We understand that change is the process. And we will follow the process and the procedures. We will continue to mount pressure on the Nigerian leaders. We will continue to ensure that we sit tight and closely until the Nigerian leaders do what they need to do, or else they resign as the president, or else they release themselves as senators,
all
or
of
else
them.
They release themselves as House of Reps, or else they release themselves as House of Assembly members, or else they release themselves as governors of the states, or else they release themselves as local government chairmen, as councillors in this country. The Nigerian politicians, we make bold to present before you people that we have seen the end of what you can ever do to us. The best you can ever do is to shoot us the way you shot our brothers and sisters in Lekki.
Ah!
The worst one we do now to shoot us the way you shoot our brothers and sisters for River State. The worst you can do to us is to kidnap us the way you kidnap our brothers and sisters in Sambisa Forest. The worst you can do to us is to deprive the Nigerians from having access to quality education. The worst you can do to us is to deprive us from having access to good and quality health. The worst you can do to us is to deprive us from having access to food. There's nothing else you can do to us anymore. Time has come. We have gotten to the back of the wall and we have bounced back.
Bouncing back.
Nigerian government, enough is enough. Please
enough
resign.
Is enough.
President Muhammadu Buhari, please resign as
resign.
The president of this country.
Resign.
Senate President, get out. Resign.
Immediately.
House of Rep, please resign. All of you, collapse this country. We need total restructuring in this country. Nigeria must be restructured. We must promote what true federalism works and the peculiarity of true federalism in the Nigerian context. The Nigerian people must begin to educate themselves. We must begin to teach ourselves what is governance. The Nigerian people must begin to educate themselves and begin to teach themselves what it means to be transparent in governance. The Nigerian people must begin to educate themselves and teach themselves what it means to be accountable. The Nigerian people must understand accountability in governance.
Our leaders are not accountable.
That the Nigerian leaders were elected.
Chief.
That the Nigerian leaders were selected. That the Nigerian leaders were appointed to go and serve. The Nigerian people must understand the difference between leaders, leadership, and servants. The Nigerian people must understand the correlation that exists between leadership and servanthood. That our Nigerian politicians are not our leaders, but instead, our Nigerian politicians are our servants. That the Nigerian politicians must sit down and open their eyes over the night and ponder and think about the way forward of how the Nigerian state should look like. That the Nigerian politicians should not have access to AC in their offices, should not have access to food in their houses until the Nigerian masses have access to quality education. That the Nigerian politicians must not have access to SUV jeep until the Nigerian children have access to quality education, have access to quality health. Until the Nigerian people age 60 years and above can have access to security, social security. Where those who are 60 years and above can at least have access to
the
benefit of what it means to be a citizen of a country. The Nigerian people must understand what it means to be a citizen. You must understand that you can never continue to live as a citizen of your country.
Like a slave.
Like a slave.
No, who does that?
The Nigerian people must open their eyes and wake up to the reality.
To take the bull by the horn.
Of the fact that we must take up the bull by the horn.
Now!
The Nigerian people must wake up to realize the fact that we must put an end to political slavery. The Nigerian government has enslaved us enough. We have been so enslaved for years. The Nigerian people must wake up.
Fear.
We must put fear aside and understand that courage is not the absence of fear, but courage is the mastery of fear. We must understand that not until me and you face that fear will continue to conquer us. The Nigerian people must realize that if we fail to come out, someday our neighboring brothers and sisters
will be gone.
In the African countries,
they'll take over.
We come to our nation and take over.
We're already doing
it. The Nigerian people must wake up to realize the fact that since we cannot make our refinery work, the country, the Niger, Republic of Niger, will make the refinery work and enslave us. Why? Because the sole aim of what we depend on as our general income as a country is from Niger. The Nigerian people must open their eyes and realize the fact that time has come
for a change,
for us to push the Nigerian dream.
My people,
that Nigerian dream is possible.
Possible.
We believe in that Nigerian dream. Possible. The president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria can never stop this dream.
Never.
The president in the Senate can never stop this dream.
Never.
House of Rep can never stop this dream. The hoodlums on the street
cannot stop
can never stop this dream.
Cannot stop it.
The evil prophets
cannot stop it.
Who are praying for our evil leaders can never stop this
can
dream.
Can never.
Do you know why? Because God sees our hearts and He knows that we are standing for what is true. He knows that we are standing for what is right. He knows that we are standing for a generation, an innocent generation, that knows nothing about what led Nigeria to where we are today. He knows that the Nigerian people have suffered enough.
Freedom.
He knows that the giant of Africa, the wings are cut off. He knows that the giant of Africa
like chicken.
Has lost his pride as a giant.
Like chicken.
He knows that the giant of Africa, as we speak, is now the number three most terroristic country in the world. God knows that the giant of Africa has lost his giant stride. The Nigerian people must wake up. The Nigerian people must realize that Nigeria will never work until Nigerians take up the bull by the horn. The Nigerian people must realize that we must unite ourselves as one people. We must unite ourselves as one nation to push and pursue the Nigerian dream. The Nigerian people must realize that we can achieve this in speaking one voice. The Nigerian people must realize that only Nigerians can build Nigeria. The Nigerian people must realize that emancipation is not a child's play. The Nigerian people must realize that to make Nigeria work is not a day job. The Nigerian people must realize that we must continue to push. We must continue to push until we get to Eldorado.
My people, we have more to say, but we'll continue from here tomorrow. Yes, sir. I don't need to be in America to say the truth. I don't need to be outside the country to talk to the leaders. No. I am in this country with them. I am not afraid to tell the people the truth. Fear. God has not given to us the spirit of fear, but of love and of sound mind. I do not need to go into hiding to talk. No. I'm on the streets. We're on the street talking. People are watching. We are not afraid of the arrow that fly by day, nor the terror that move fly by night. Because one with God is majority. One with God is majority. We will fight this monster in the corridor of power. Enough is enough. Tomorrow we continue from here. We move. We move.
We move.
We move. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you for joining this broadcast. Thank you for inviting your friends. Thank you for sharing this broadcast. United we stand.
And divided we fall.
We have made up our mind to take the bull by the horn. 1,000 will continue to fall by our left hand side. Let them get the national rock against us. They shall not prosper, neither will their weapon prevail. For the arm of flesh shall fail, because we depend on Christ, the solid rock.
Solid rock alone.
We stand on Christ,
the solid rock.
We are not afraid of any man.
Yeah.
We are not afraid of any woman. The Bible said, fear not, for I am with thee. I will keep you and I will preserve you. That is the word of assurance for us. God has assured us that is with us. We move. We are not afraid of the political evil arrow that fly by day. We are not afraid of the political weapon that fly by night. Why? Because we are with Christ.
The hope.
The hope of glory. The Bible says the city set on the hill cannot be hidden.
At all.
Our voice cannot be hidden.
At all.
We are not afraid of any man born by a woman. Let me tell you, the Bible said, do not be afraid of those that can kill the body, but rather fear whom that can destroy both soul and body in hell. We are only afraid of Jesus, the master of the universe. Yeah. We are not afraid of any mortal human being, because the Bible says that the heart of the king is in the hand of God. We are not afraid. We move. Martin Luther King Jr. did I have a dream that one day our honor is that the dream have started.
Yeah.
We are no longer dreaming. We are moving forward. We are not afraid of any human being born of a woman, because we are dead to Christ. We have ready, we have sworn an oath to take the bull by the horn. Until we see the freedom that we seek for, we will not stop talking.
At all.
Don't pity us. You have no need to pity us.
Don't be fearful. Don't be
Apostle.
Scared on our behalf.
No! Don't pity us. Don't pity us.
Don't be scared on our behalf.
Don't be scared.
Nothing.
If you love her too much, just pray for us. That's all. We are not afraid of any bastard. We are not afraid of anybody. Enough is enough. Girlfriend, truth. No, it's boyfriend.
At all.
What is not good,
extremely bad.
Is bad. We move. Nigeria must change. We can no longer be oppressed again in our own land. We can no longer be slave again in our own land. I cry every day, see men and women that can't feed for themselves. The skim meal, 101
better now.
001 nothing.
000.
We are not afraid. We are not afraid. We are not afraid because of Jesus is on our side. We are not afraid. We are not afraid. We are not afraid because Jesus is on our side. Tell people whenever I hear. Share Apostle Alfred and Holy Say. They are ready. The Bible says one will chase 1,000, two will chase 10,000. How did God did the geometric projection?
We don't know. No concern you.
I'm not aware. As we round up this broadcast tonight, anyone that is angry because of the decision we have taken to fight against us, you will kill yourself. Any politician that wants to sponsor anybody to say go and attack Apostle Alfred and Holy Say, you will die with your instrument. You will use your hand to destroy your generation. You will use your hand to sponsor what will destroy your generation. Because we have prayed enough.
Yes.
Time for action. We are taking this country out of you guys' hand. We move.
We move.
We move. God bless every one of you. We are ready for a change. And the change begins now.
Now.
God bless you and have a blessed day. See you guys tomorrow. We'll continue to say the way it is. I know some Christians will say, Apostle, they come to die. Apostle, say Nigeria don't die. That's the truth. Nigeria is dead. Nigeria is dead. When you plant any seed, the seed need to die for that to grow again.
Rema.
When you plant corn, the corn need to die for a new one to come out. Nigeria is dead. And we need a new Nigeria.
Nigeria
is dead. We need a new Nigeria.
The
Nigeria is dead. We need a new Nigeria.
Spirit of God rebates.
Enough is enough.
Spirit of God rebates Nigeria.
We are not afraid.
Rebates Nigeria. Spirit of God.
Rebates.
Rebates Nigeria.
We demand for a new Nigeria.
In the name of Jesus.
We demand for a new Nigeria.
Spirit of God. Rebate Nigeria in the name of Jesus. Rebate Nigeria.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Keep praying for us. If you love us, keep praying for us. Nobody should pity me. Nobody should pity us.
At all.
To say, Apostle Alfred. Yes, you are free, man. Oh, Apostle Alfred. Oh, they should attack you. Nobody can attack us.
They cannot do anything.
They cannot do anything.
My man.
They don't do anything.
They don't do anything.
Nothing. Don't pity me, don't cry for me. Don't cry for me. Don't pity me. Don't pity us. We are ready. My mentor, I will continue to call his name. Dr. Sunday Adelaja. Each time I look at, listen to him. We are ready. My second mentor, late Archbishop Bessie Dahosa, the man of power, and Martin Luther King Jr. These are the people we are following, not chicken. Bless my people, let's go, my brother.
Spirit of God, we ask that you reign in our nation.
Amen.
We ask that the call and the yearn for a new Nigeria shall be bestowed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We ask that our cry to build a new nation, that from now henceforth, we ask that we receive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The strength to raise leaders.
Amen.
The strength to raise people.
Amen.
The strength to unite Nigeria.
Amen.
We ask that you unite us from wherever we may be in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, whatever you need to do to make Nigeria work,
do it, Lord.
That we give you authority.
Do it,
in
Lord.
The name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we pray that from now henceforth, the seed that is dead shall begin to rebirth.
Now.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The seed of a nation that is dead will begin to say, receive life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your rain fall upon this nation.
Amen.
Let your rain fall upon this nation.
Amen.
Let your rain fall upon this nation.
Amen.
Arrest our leaders.
Amen.
Arrest our leaders.
Amen.
Arrest our leaders.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we bless your holy name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for the gift.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you for the wisdom.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Nigerians.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Nigerians.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Nigerians in diaspora.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Nigerians in right here in Nigeria.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Nigerians anywhere they may be.
Yes, Lord.
That we ask that whatever our heart desires might be, that we pray that you grant us our heart desires in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We ask that anywhere anybody may be, they may gather and they are planning evil. That we pray that the spirit of stroke
will direct them
in the name of Jesus.
Kill them in the name of Jesus Christ.
The spirit of stroke.
Hit them.
Hit them in the name of
now,
Jesus.
Now, in the name of Jesus. Hit their generation.
We stand on a solid rock.
Yes, Lord.
I say, Nigeria, receive breath.
Right.
We say, Nigeria, receive breath.
Now.
We say, Nigeria, receive breath.
Now.
Receive breath.
Now.
Receive breath.
Now.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. All right, see the view. See the view. Yeah. We're on top of the hill. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. We're on top of a hill. Let the whole world see. We are coming. God bless you. Catch you.
Thank you.